In a previous video, we covered some basic input channel functions. These were things like EQ, dynamics, panning, and assigning signal from that input channel to a mix bus. Now let's cover some more advanced topics. Things like mute groups, DCAs, channel links, and changing your input patch. There are certain occasions where you may want to change the default input patch for a channel. Instead of having that channel receive its audio from the Dante port, you may prefer to have that channel receive audio from a slot or one of the Omni inputs. This can be done by changing the input patch. Let's take a look at that now. To change the input patch for one of your channels, touch on the current input patch in the gain area. This will bring up your patch and name pop-up window. Selecting the patch tab will allow you to view the current patch for that particular input channel. If I wish to select another Dante input port, an Omni input port, or one of the slots as the input to my channel, I can do so by pressing here. Now channel number one, which is my kick, will receive its input from slot number two, port number one. Keep in mind, you have the ability to send a single input port to multiple input channels. Let's go ahead and close this pop-up and talk about the steps necessary to link two channels together. I have my two keyboard faders right here, and I want to link them so that when I bring up the left side, the right side will come along as well. We can do so by going to the Channel Job menu. I'm going to touch where it says Channel Job on the right-hand side of the screen. Then touch Channel Link. On your Channel Link window, you want to hold down the Select button of one of those channels and then press the Select button of the other channel to create that channel link. Now these two keyboard faders are going to move together. In addition to our faders changing at the same time, you also have the ability to link other parameters. Your links can vary by channel. If you wish to have one set of channels with only a few parameters linked, and another set of channels with multiple links, you can do that as well. Linking channels across fader banks can be accomplished by touching in this middle section. This opens up your channel link set pop-up window. If I wish to link channel 25 with channel 70, I can do so by selecting them and then pressing Link. Now these two channels are a part of the same group. Next, let's walk through the steps necessary to assign your channel to a DCA group. There are two different ways to assign the channel to a DCA group. This can be done by touching on the DCA number in your DCA area while looking at your selected channel section. A faster way of assigning channels to a DCA group is from the channel job window. Selecting DCA group brings up your DCA group pop-up window. Pressing the select button on the channels that you wish to add to that group will make them a part of that DCA. To select a different group, simply press on the icon with that number. If you wish to assign a single channel to a mute group, we can do so by using the same methodology. First, touch the Mute tab when looking at the selected channel window. Next, press the number for the mute group that you wish to assign that channel to. This is a great way of assigning a single channel to a single mute group. If you wish to assign multiple channels to a single mute group, you can do so from the channel job window. On the right-hand side of your screen, touch where it says mute group. Press the select button on each channel that you wish to add to that group. Now, we can activate that mute group by pressing on the Mute Group Master user-defined key. For more information on how your user-defined keys are configured by default, please take a look at that video. If you wish to have your channels only partially attenuate when you activate a mute group, you can do so by using the Mute Group Dimmer. Let's build an example using mute group number 2. First, I'm going to select mute group number 2. Next, I'm going to set the level for that dimmer. After that, press the select button on the channels that you wish to add to that mute group. Now, when the mute group master for mute group number 2 is activated, those channels will dim by 20 dBs.